Here are a few use cases for importing or exporting data to and from your planning application. Planning supports data loads in and out of applications using data integration, REST APIs, EPM Automate, migration when importing an application for the first time, and the native import-export utility in planning. In this video, I'll show you how you can quickly and easily use the import-export utility in planning. With a new application, you can typically import data from an external source. Your source data must be in a business process-specific data file format or in an Oracle Essbase data file format. In this case, I'll run the export process first so I can use the exported data file as a template. In Export Data, select Options for your data export. For Location, select if you want to export the data file to your local computer or save it in the Outbox. Exporting to a local system allows you to run the process immediately. Exporting to the Outbox requires you to save the process as a job and run it from Job Scheduler. Next, select a cube. For file type, select the file delimiter you want for your data file. If you are using smart lists, select if you want to export labels or names. For block storage cubes, select whether to include or exclude dense dynamic calculation members during export. For aggregate storage cubes, select whether to include dynamic calculation members during export. Excluding dynamic calculation members from exported data improves performance during data exports. You can specify the number of decimal positions to format the data after export. The default option is none. This uses the default precision formatting set in your application. Next, in slice definition, select the data set you want to export. You export asymmetric data sets. You select the dense dimension for the row, a dense dimension for the column, and the rest of the dimensions in the POV. I'll select account members for the row. When selecting members, you can filter the members that are displayed in the member list, show or hide the members' alias names and counts, sort members, and refresh the dialog. You can search for specific members and use member functions to select the set of members in the hierarchy. Next, I'll select period members for the column. I'll select members for the POV. Before proceeding with the data export, always verify your selections. Depending on how your browser is set, you may be prompted to save your file. Close both export dialogs and navigate to jobs. The exported data job displays that it completed successfully. I'll navigate to where I saved the file. Data files are packaged in a zip file. I'll extract and open the file to review its contents. The exported data is displayed. Now, I'll export data to the Outbox using the same selections I made. With this option, you save your job selections. You can then choose to run the job right away or schedule it to run later. I'll save my selections as a job. Notice that the job is now listed in the Export Data dialog. Use the Actions menu to delete or run the job. I'll navigate to Jobs to review its status. The job completed successfully. You can now download the data file from the Job Details page or Inbox Outbox Explorer. You can also schedule to run the job later. I'll navigate to Inbox Outbox Explorer and show you where the exported data file is saved on the server. Here is my exported data file. Using the Actions menu, delete or download the file. If you want to create an import data job, you'll need to upload the file here. The data file contains 5 data records for the same data point of view we exported, but the target cube is planned too. I'll be using this form to verify my data load. I'll return to the import-export utility and start the import process. Option selections are similar to the exporting data process. Select if you want to load from a local data file or from a file in the inbox. I'll start by importing from a local file. Source type refers to how the data file is formatted. Is it business process specific or in Essbase format? Select the file type or delimiter used in your data file. Next, select your source data file. Include metadata allows you to modify the positions of your members during data import. Regardless of this option setting, the required metadata must already exist in your application and outline before you can load any application data to it. You can select the date format used in your file. As a precaution, validate your data files before running the import process. If errors are found, you can modify the file as required and revalidate it. It is also recommended to perform this task before you upload your source data file to the inbox. The data file was validated successfully. 5 records were read and 5 records were processed. I'll return to the import data dialog and re-enter my selections. Then, run the data import. I'll verify that the job completed successfully, then open the form to view the data. The exported data is displayed. I'll clear the cube data before running another data import. I'll set up the import data options based on my previous run. But this time, I'll select inbox for location and use the file I uploaded. After verifying selections, save the job. Provide a name for the job and a name for the error file should the import run into issues. The job is now listed on the import data page. I'll submit the job for processing and review the job status. The job completed successfully with no errors. Now, I'll open my form to verify that the data loaded. The exported data is displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.